now have an MBA. I've also been active in the community. When my son was young, I was on a PTO board. I am an ordained minister, and I am very passionate about our children and their education. I feel no child should be denied anything regardless of their abilities and their background. I want to make sure that we have the tools and resources for our parents, the teachers, and our students to succeed. Every child should be able to benefit from school, to stay in school, and to graduate. And I feel that if they fail, we fail. So I want to be on the board to help bring our accreditation up and our rating up. And one time, for course, it was number one of all the schools. We accredited, but we're not up there. So I want to help make sure that we get up there. Our rating from 1 to 10 is number 4. That's between the elementary, middle schools, and also the high schools. It should be a 9 or 10. It should be 4 on average. That's because some of our reading levels are low. So we need to bring our reading levels up for the students. Once that's up, they'll do good in test scores, and it will benefit everybody. And I feel with us working together, we can make a better education and brighter future for our children. It's all about the children.
Thank you, Ms. Harge. Ms. Hogshead, tell us about your background, what experiences and qualifications you would bring to the Board of Education that would benefit the school district. Mr. Hines, tell us about your background, what experiences and qualifications you would bring to the Board of Education that would benefit the school district.
Customers and consumers around the country. basketball, baseball, soccer, flag football coach for my children for many, many years. I'm a senior this year, so I've been coaching them for 12 years now. As far as, you know, how could I, my education background benefit the district? It's going to benefit the district with sound and solid decision-making processes. I do it every day in my work, in my career, and I think I can definitely bring that knowledge, that expertise to the board, which I'm not saying that it's lacking, but from a fresh perspective.
Ms. Hogshead, second question. What motivates you to become a member of the school board, and what will be your primary focus? Ms. Hines, what motivates you to become a member of the school board, and what will be your primary focus? Or excuse me, Mr. Hines, I apologize. Sorry. All the H's, sorry about that. What motivates you to become a member of the school board, and what will be your primary focus? Mr. Hines.
Thank you. My motivation for this quest to get on the school board was when we started a couple of years ago when our community entered some and started having some. A lot of our children were affected by the actions that took place in our community. And as I sat my personal children down, and I was talking about what was going on and telling them that they needed to, that they had to work in the community to make a difference. And, you know, I realized at a certain point that I was doing that sitting on my couch. And I was not showing them that you had to be actively working in the community to make a difference. And I thought this was, the school board was the best way, because it had been in the news for a couple of years with different incidents and scenarios. And I thought this was a good opportunity to get involved and try to help make some good decisions for our school and our community. The challenges that many of our students have, some of them are not dictated by what goes on in school necessarily. They're dictated by what goes on in their homes, which bleeds over in the school. And we need to be able to effectively address those that we can so that those students can have the best benefits possible. And, you know, as I got further and further engaged in the district meetings and what was going on district-wide as opposed to just what was taking place at my children.
Ms. Harge, what motivates you to become a member of the school board, and what will be your primary focus?
Education for children. You know, every child should have a chance to have a good education, no matter what the problem is. We have to come up with ways to find out and get more of the parents involved. Why are some of the parents not involved? So we have to come up with ways to get the parents involved so they can help their kids to succeed. We need to make sure that the students and teachers have everything that they need, because that brings the community up. And one of the problems we have are the community problems that are in the school. So I want to be on the board to find out what is the problem, why are some kids lacking that? And it hurts me to know that there are some kids struggling, and I want to be a part to bring them up. I feel that all kids are our kids, not just one. And I just feel that somewhere along the line, they will let down. I don't know if it's home. If it is, we need to find out what ways we can help them when it comes to home. Parents. If the parents are struggling, we need to help the parents. If our teachers are having problems, we need to help the problems. I support our superintendent, Dr. Davis. He has some good plans to roll out to bring our accreditation up, to bring our reading skills up, so that every child will be able to succeed, to pass the test, and make a good grade on the test. Because that will help not only going to college, but help them as far as securing a good job. Without that, we have nothing. And as I said before, if our children fail, we fail then. We need to make sure that every child, some children have challenges, but the ones that are in home or up, we need to keep them there. The ones in the middle part, we need to move them up. The ones that are struggling, we need to find out what we need to do to help them. Every child deserves a chance, and I don't feel that no matter what we need to do, look at our budget, we need to help out with the things that they need. Every child doesn't have the same thing, and we need to make sure, because that is their prepares our future, that would help the community also. So we need to just develop and find ways, and I have a very passionate for children and education, and I want to see everyone succeed, every student.
Mr. Hines, explain your vision for moving the school district forward. Thank you.
schools better opportunities.
Ms. Harge, explain your vision for moving the school district forward.
With the teachers and working with the students.
Okay, that concludes the first section of our questions. Now we're going to open up to the questions that the audience has submitted. You have 2 minutes to answer those questions, and we'll do a rolling order as we did in the first section. So the first question goes to Ms. Harge. And all three candidates will have the opportunity to answer this question. Ms. Harge, budget control is a concern. What experience do you have with budgeting that makes you a good fit to serve on the board? Ms. Hogshead, budget control is a concern. What experience do you have with budgeting that makes you a good fit to serve on the board? Mr. Hines, budget control is a concern. What experience do you have with budgeting that makes you a good fit to serve the board? Sure. How do you propose providing building principals authority to enforce violations of the code of conduct? And how will you support teachers with students that are disrupting in the classroom? We'll start with Ms. Hogshead. Mr. Hines, how do you propose providing building principals authority to enforce violations of the code of conduct? And how will you support teachers with students that are disrupting in the classroom? Ms. Harge, how do you propose providing building principals authority to enforce violations of the code of conduct and support teachers with students that are disrupting in the classroom?
Child is on off-site suspension,
Okay, this first, this next question will be open to the panel. Mr. Hines, you will start with the question. How important do you feel the arts are in elementary education? Arts are described by this person as music, art, physical education, and library. How important do you feel the arts are in elementary education? Music, art, physical education, and the library?
I think it's very important. It motivates our students. When they have art, music, and physical education, that helps motivate them to want to do well and to succeed in school. You take that out, I mean, they just look at it as a whole, more than think of learning this and that and the other. And so I think it's very important. A lot of children are very gifted when it comes to art. So I think that's very important to keep that in our schools. As far as physical education, that's very important because a lot of students, when they go home, all they do is sit in front of a computer, internet, on their phone. They're not getting any exercise. Physical education is very important. It helps their well-being, helps them keep them energized and motivated. And without that, I think we're losing something. You take art away, you have some children that really excel really good at being an artist. I mean, what are they going to do? You know, they look at other things that maybe they don't excel in. They're just on the average. Music is very good. It's kind of relaxing. Something that motivates them as well. And I feel that we do have some musicians and physical education. Like I said, if you take that out, those children are not there going home. They're not doing anything for physical education. They're not exercising. That is a very important part. That helps the child as far as his well-being, his growing, stay in school, and want to do well. So I think all three of these subjects are very important to keep in school for our students to do well.
Ms. Hogshead, how important do you feel the arts are in elementary education? Music, art, physical education, and library?
Art pictures that they may see. It also helps when It can also provide, the arts can also provide scholarships for students that if they learn it in the elementary school, they will be able to move through the ranks and go further. PE especially, besides the physical part, it teaches you how to cooperate with each other. It teaches you how to get along. You don't have to be on the football team, but if you're playing a game, you have to learn to cooperate in playing that game. And it's a strength that children need to learn. They need to know that they can play with others and still move forward and have fun at it. So I support all of the arts, and it's helped me in my culture. It's helped me, as well as I'm sure all of you through the years, learn more about life and stuff. So I think we need it.
The next question for all three candidates, we'll start with Ms. Harge. Do you favor school board elections by sub-districts over the current at-large system?
Yeah.
Repeat it, absolutely. Do you favor school board elections by sub-districts over the current at-large system? Ms. Hogshead, do you favor school board elections by sub-districts over the current at-large system?
I favor the at-large system, and I feel that it is important for us to be one district and one district united. I'm being the copycat, Dr. Wiggins. But it's a large district, and if we get, at one time there were five school board members from board member from Berkeley and one school board member from Ferguson. And you need to know, we need to all work together for the betterment of all of our students. And by being from throughout the whole school, you don't, or from the whole district, it keeps the finances balanced, and it just helps keep everybody working together to make sure that we're all here for all of our students. And I tell you, the way our community moves now, that one day you might be in Florissant and the next day you might be in Cool Valley and Ferguson, it's better that the students have the opportunity of hearing the voices of school board members throughout the entire district.
Mr. Hines, do you favor school board elections by sub-districts over the current at-large system?
I don't know that I favor one over the other. We currently work in the at-large system. And I mean, if we worked in districts, it would be, I think the political structure would be just as strong, just as fierce. parents and the other parents about one issue. And as long as those, our candidates are doing what they believe is truly best for our students, and what they believe is truly best for our community, I think either structure would work just fine. There's obviously pros and cons to both structures. I think that, you know, when you do it at large, you get a bigger variety or you have a bigger pool to pick from. It's not just strictly, you're not stuck strictly to one community, which is a good thing. But I think that when you single it down to just the sub-district, status to support just that sub-district. And that can be good, it can be bad. But like I said, I don't know that I favor one over the other necessarily. I believe that either political structure would work. I think the way we're working now is good. Could it be better? There's always improvements that can be made. Should we make the change? I'm not 100% sold on the change should be made.
Okay, the next question, we'll start with Ms. Hogshead. Would you share an occasion when you strongly disagreed with the views of someone else, however it was necessary that you come to a common ground on the matter? I'll repeat it again. Would you share an occasion when you strongly disagreed with the views of someone else, however it was necessary to come to a common ground on the matter? Yes, ma'am. Would you share an occasion when you strongly disagreed with the views of someone else, however it was necessary you come to a common ground on the matter? Mr. Hines, would you share an occasion when you strongly disagreed with the views of someone else, however it was necessary to come to some common ground on the matter?
Everything that myself myself and the other candidates and the rest of the school board and everything that they do, I know, I hope in my heart that they're doing, because they feel that it's in the best interest of the children. And sometimes, you know, you may not be the only idea in the world, and you have to compromise that such as that. I hope I answered that question, that is, it didn't really give any insight into where the questions want to end up. But can I work with others? Without a doubt, that's what I do every day. Will I try to impose my will? Sure, that's what I do.
Ms. Harge, would you share an occasion when you strongly disagreed with the views of someone else? However, it was necessary to come to some common ground on the matter.
Whenever I'm in a disagreement with a person, I always try to look at the positive and look at all the facts. The other person has facts, I have facts. Let's put our facts together and do our resources and find out what is going on, what do we need. So that's what we did. Both of us sit down, okay, everybody presents their facts. Grab the tape and find out, okay,
Ms. Harge, please explain why the constituents should vote for you on April 5th.
I'm a very honest and sincere person. I look at everything in a positive light. I don't look at it negative. In the universe, and I feel this is for the education for our children. I believe that all of us can work together and try to all have the same goal in mind to bring the ratings up in the school, keep our accreditation, to raise that up, and to make sure no child is struggling. If they are, we need to give them help. And I'm very passionate for our children. I want to help our children and see what is it that they're lacking. I want to also help the teachers. I feel the parents should have a voice. If they're struggling, we need to help them too. And we need to help the community and stay active. So I'm very passionate when it comes to our education. My two children, one of them does computer work, the other one is a RN with a BSA. I was very much on education for them and making sure that they had the things that they needed. If not, I would not help. I feel we should help.
Ms. Hogshead, please explain why the constituents should vote for you on April 5th. This concludes the questions for this evening. Thank you very much for coming, and a round of applause for our candidates.